Hey you guys, we're gonna go ahead and make some trays. So I went ahead and mixed up some resin and I added the black acrylic craft paint to it. I'm going to stir that up. My bottle burst at the top, so I ended up making a mess. Because I'm trying to get into the little channels, I'm going to use a Dixie cup because I can pinch it. I always keep my paper towels and baby wipes nearby. We're just going to pour it into the channels. I'm probably going to make a mess, but that's okay. I enjoy this. So it'll connect before we go on to the next one. Cleaned these before, but a hair managed to get on my tray. After my last pour, I'm a little more conscious of it. I had a hair stuck in the tray. Tray. I was making a clock. If you're a subscriber, you saw it. If you're not a subscriber, you could be. make sure I have enough for all of them. And then I'll go back and top off if I have to. If you're a resin artist, then you know to keep baby wipes on hand also. And if you're just getting started, pro tip, necessary thing to have. And I'll show you why in just a minute. If I do this video right, there should be a little picture-in-picture of our new pup, Reba. Oh my gosh. You know what? I'm not wearing my headscarf. I just realized. That's okay. Just have to be looking. Of course I'm. Why would I? That would be too easy. Okay, baby wipes. You could also use a paper towel sprayed with rubbing alcohol. Up the resin, but baby wipes work best, in my opinion. Doing this little exercise right here has been great for my therapy, physical therapy, on controlling my tremors. Wow, I got a lot of black left. Tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm heat it up so it'll flow easier. And pop the bubbles. You don't have to fill that channel up all the way. I do like it. And since they're my trays, that's the important part. although I do create items that I know the general public will like, everything starts with something I like. And if I can make it more adaptable for the public, I will do that. If not, some of my pieces are pretty outrageous, and I don't show those in public. Well, not on my YouTube channel, because sometimes kids watch. I know that because my niece and nephew watch. My nephew was in one of my videos making resin with me. My niece is going to be doing one too once she comes out to visit. To have patience for this. Some days I just don't have patience. I'm trying to learn it. I think that's as much as I'm going to fill them up. So I'm going to clean them real quick. There's a reason we wear aprons when we do this. I've ruined pants, shirts, a pair of shoes once. So now I have a complete resin outfit. When I'm working. Alright, now a clean one. funny. Let's do it slow. Remember? Still learning patience. Don't judge me. Alright, now I also want to look on the sides, like here, to see if there's any drops clinging. We want those off because it's black, and when it cures,
you're gonna have little black beads showing in the next layer. You could also wrap your baby wipe around pencil or stick, popsicle stick, and use that. And then you wouldn't be going through this. I do have excess left, so we're gonna make some crystals. Yeah, crystals. But if we're making crystals, we're gonna take what's left. Glitter to it. Never tried adding black glitter to black. I don't even know if it'll work. It may not reflect, refract the light, just in case it doesn't. Let's put a dash of white glitter. And flakes, cellophane flakes. Okay. We gotta hurry. No, I don't think that black glitter. Well, now we know, right? No, we'll just have to wait and see. So what I'm going to do is turn that upside down on my table because I have this plastic. And then I'm going to spray in here. It because there's a point, and if there's an air bubble trapped in there, I want it out. Too much.
It's okay. I'm going to show you how to fix that. Like making a cake, you take a popsicle stick and swipe it across the top. I should pour this so I can pinch it along with the other one. Now there's two on here I don't really like. It's the square one at the end here and a rectangle one.
And for what I use them for, that doesn't work for me. popsicle stick. Yeah, this one comes into like a pyramid shape. I don't know, obelisk? Some left, and I hate to waste. What could I use it on? Oh, that's a good idea. We'll use it for a jar lid. I don't think it will fill the whole mold up, but it will definitely fill up the channel. Maybe it will. I could always go in. Fill it with something else afterwards. Like solid black. No, that's fine. Same thing, I'm gonna pinch. I should probably do that on camera. Pinch the sides so that if there's any air trapped in the channel, you'll get it out. I do see the black glitter. Well, I just have to wait and see. It for now. We'll come back tomorrow and do the next experimenting. I'm going to take a recipe I normally do and I'm going to change it. I'm using interference pink, interference violet, interference green, and interference blue, and then I'm going to be using craft paint white. It's Apple brand that I'm using. I put my mica into my cups before I pour resin in, because it helps it mix better. I also do two stirs. And what I mean by that, as you see, I'm mixing it up. But then after I get everything mixed, I'll go back around and give it a second mixing. I love working with mica, especially interference colors. Interference colors show up best when you have a black background, but that's not what I'm doing. Okay, this is my
That was a resin cup that just fell on the floor, an empty one. Now, since I've never done this before, I'm not sure how much to use. I appear to have a stuck nozzle. Just a little. And that looks like it's gonna be just right. I want it to be white and a little translucent. But I don't want full translucence, and I don't want you to be able to see through it. So that's why I'm not using alcohol ink. Plus, there's the interaction between the acrylic paint and the mica. It doesn't blend as easily with each other, so that's good. Okay, so I'm gonna go back and do a second stir. This is why. Can you see the little clumps? Scrape it on the side. See how the clumps start rising to the top. When I experiment in these videos, it's for a reason. Because when I'm making orders for people, I'm gonna use the tricks that I learn when I'm experimenting. If I do something and it turns out good, then the second time, when I intend to do it, it comes out great. A lot of times my experiments don't work, but I always feel better knowing I tried than just sat there going, I wonder what would have happened. All right, I have this chunky glitter, and against my better judgment, I'm gonna put some in, but not a lot. Normally I'd tip it over into it because I really like glitter. But I just want a few bits to catch the eye, so that's all I'm putting in. See, it disappears nicely. Okay. I know what's going to happen. Once I pour it, those big chunks are going to settle. And when I flip it over, there's going to be a lot of glitter there. I'm wondering if I put too much. Let's find out. All right. So I'm going to switch this. To make sure I have enough white for both trays. I do. And if you're watching, I wonder. If you haven't seen Wanda in Wanda's Blessed Creations, check her out. She is adorable. I love you, Wanda. You're a doll. Doesn't hurt to give it another quick mix-a-doodle. Mix-a-doodle. Okay. Oh, there's two cups. I can feel the cups getting warm. Now all I'm gonna do is start pouring it on willy-nilly-ish. Do it in thin streaks. And alternate with the white. Track of what I was doing. That's okay. I should say it out loud so I don't get confused. Here's blue. Alright, a little white. Green.
Almost poured a lot of wrong color in there.
Look, the glitter sank to the bottom of the cup, which is fine because that means only the lighter pieces of glitter went in. I'm happy. Alright. I'm so happy about the glitter, I forgot what I was doing. I may have enough resin for another tray. We'll see. Let's mix up the order. Excuse me. Can you see the effect it's having? Kind of abalone-ish, opal-ish. I can't decide if it's abalone or opal. I think this white edition is going to work out just fine. Sometimes I take the concentrated nozzle on my heat gun and give it a little forced blending. But I don't think I'm going to do that this time. I'm going to let everything happen on its own. And experiment and see what happens. Oh, I was going to tell you a fun trick to do. If you're making the gift for somebody, you could do sometimes. I take this and I say, Oscar. Just keep going back and forth. I think I'm out of white. Yeah, I was expecting that. Let's do some of this. I feel my resin spirits talking to me. I haven't seen a lot of Opal style trays out there. I wonder if there's a better recipe for it. So if anybody comes across one, shoot me the link, because I'd love to see it. Green, huh? Goodbye, Mr. Green. It's been fun. Have to ask the people in my epoxy stoner group that I belong to if they have any opal recipes. Perfect. So I know that once the channel is filled up with whatever color I choose, 10 ounces will fill up two trays. So 5 ounces fills up one. I'm very good at math. I'm loving the way these are looking already. I'm just wondering about that glitter. I'm excited to see how it comes out. Oh yeah. That white did good. Good job, good job. Give it a little pop the bubble itch. Let's see how black line looks nice and crisp even through the mold. It's because we let it cure. Okay, it might be working. Look at
Can you see the different colors? I don't know how well this is coming over on camera, but oh yeah, I can definitely see traces of pink and the blue. Looking good. Okay. Oh. Oh, yes. Yes. You see not very many large pieces of glitter ended up there. I'm trying to get it to focus properly. I'm very pleased. Now let's see the other one. Okay, the visible effects in the mold. You can't really see from this angle. But as soon as we peel it back, pink, blue highlights. I would have liked to have seen it with more green. Oh, there's the green. Okay, this, let's see. Ugh. I can't make this thing focus. Anyway, see here, those black dots. That is where I didn't clean the sides as well as I thought. Everywhere else looks good, but that one spot, I knew that was gonna happen. See? That's okay. Because it's still gorgeous. Now, I'm gonna go ahead and put some designs on here, and we will look at the final results in the morning.